Please do subscribe to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel and also turn on the bell notifications to receive the updates of our videos directly in your device. Hello friends, I Vikas Nehra welcome you all to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel. Friends, in today's tutorial, we will learn how to configure SSH port forwarding or SSH tunneling in RHEL 8 or in CentOS 8. But before doing the practical, let me give you the brief idea about SSH port forwarding. SSH port forwarding or tunneling allows you to forward otherwise insecure TCP traffic inside a secure SSH tunnel from local computer to the destination server. Protocols such as FTP, POP3, SMTP, HTTP, Telnet and others can all be forwarded inside this SSH tunnel. This will provide increased security features such as encryption, authentication that may not otherwise be supported. You must create a new SSH connection to establish the tunneling. Here, let me show you the SSH tunneling. In this picture, we have two different modes of communication. In the upper half of this picture, we have two machines, server 1 and server 2. Which are connected to each other with the help of SSH, and here we are not using SSH tunneling, so the data transmission is not 100% secure between them. But in case if we use SSH tunneling, means if we create SSH tunnel between server 1 and server 3 that is shown in the below picture, the data transmission is encrypted and is 100% secured. Now in today's tutorial, I will show you how can you create the tunnel and how can you use the SSH port forwarding in different modes. But before that, let me tell you what are the different types of SSH port forwarding. So we use three types of port forwarding for SSH. First one is the local port forwarding, second one is the remote port forwarding, and the third one is dynamic port forwarding. The local port forwarding we use to create a local port that is connected to a remote service. In remote port forwarding, we forward a port on a remote computer on the internet to a local port. And in the third one, that is the dynamic port forwarding, a SOX client connects via TCP and indicates via the protocol the remote socket it wants to reach. Means that we can use if some ports are blocked by the firewall. Now we will perform the practicals and we will learn each type of SSH port forwarding. So without wasting time, let's get started. For this practical of SSH port forwarding, we are using three different machines here. All are running on CentOS 8 and we have logged in all the machines as the root user, and the local EM repositories are already configured in all these machines and the SSH packages are already installed in all. We have set the host names in these machines. As on machine number 1 we have set the host name as server1.ftp.nehraclasses.local. On machine number 2 we have set the host name as server2.nehraclasses.local, and on machine number 3 we have set the host name as server3.web.nehraclasses.local, and we have configured the web server on server 3 machine. Here if I execute the curl command, my web page can be displayed. That means our web server is working properly. So first of all, what we are going to learn, we will learn how to forward the local port, means how can we use local port forwarding. So the syntax for local port forwarding is SSH-L, then the source host, then colon source port, then colon, we mention the port to the host, and after the colon we mention on port connect to host. Let me show you first with the help of the diagram. Here it is. Let us suppose we are running the web server on server number 3 which uses port number 80, and if we want to connect to this port 80 from server 1, means we want to access the web page from the server 1, that is the FTP server. And in that case, if I want to use the port number 55 on this machine,
So how can I forward that port? How can I create the tunnel? So for that, we use this command, that is SSH hyphen F for the file, hyphen N for the port forwarding, hyphen L for the local. Then we mention localhost. Then we mention the name, number of the port on the localhost. After that, we mention the host name of the second machine on which the web server is running. And after that, we mention the port. Let us suppose we are using the web server port, that is port number 80. And then we mention the name of the user. So let me show you. All of this we will do from server number 1, from the local machine. So this is my server 1, that is the FTP server. Here I will execute this command to forward the port. So here I will mention SSH hyphen F hyphen N capital, then hyphen capital L, localhost 5555. And here I will mention the IP address, because I am not using the DNS here. And the IP address of my web server is 192.168.1.126. Let me mention it here. And after that, I will mention the port number, that is 80. And again, I will mention the IP address here after root at the rate. If I will press enter here, then it will prompt me. Here I will mention yes. Then it will prompt me for the password. I will have to provide the password. And now it has created the tunnel there. Now, how can I verify it? So to verify it, on the same machine, I will execute ps-ef command to see the processes, and there I can grab SSH, and here it will show me the port forwarding. Here it is. Now, what is the benefit of this? If I will use port number 55 on this machine, I can access the web server that is running on server number 3. And for that, I can simply execute curl command, curl localhost, and after the localhost, I will mention the port number. That is the local port, that is 5555. It will display the web page that is hosted on the web server, that is on server 3. Here it is. So here, what we are doing, we are using the port forwarding mechanism to access the web page that is running on this machine. Web server is running here on server 3.web.nehraclasses.local. Let me show you one more time. If I execute curl localhost command here, you will see the same web page. And if you want to know more details, you can go to the server 3 where the web server is hosted, means the web page is there. There you can execute tcp dump command, tcp dump hyphen I, and after that you can mention the adapter name, that is ENS33 in my case. And after that I can specify the port number, that is 22, and here it will display the tcp dump data there. And here you will see the details of the packets. And here it shows that the curl request was accessed through port number 22 from server 1. So in this way, we can configure the SSH port forwarding. Now I will show you how can you close it. So here we will again execute the ps-ef command, and then we will check the process ID of this service. And the service and the process ID for this service is 18710 in this case. And we will kill this process to disable this port forwarding. So we will mention here kill hyphen 9 and the process ID. And we will verify the details again with the help of the same command, that is ps-ef, and this time it will not show the port forwarding. And if you will try to use the port number 5555 to access the web server, this time you will not be able to access it. So it will give you an error, failed to connect to the localhost port 5555. So this was the method by which we can easily forward the port on the local machine, or we call it the local port forwarding. Now I'm going to show you the local port forwarding with three servers. Here we are using one more server that is working as a gateway in between server 1 and server 3. And we will try to access this web server for the web page that is hosted on this web server 3. And here we will use one more server in between them, that is server 2. So for that, what we will do, we will go on the server number 1, and there we will execute this command ssh-f-end-l, and then after that we will mention localhost and the port number, then we will mention the destination server name with the port and the user with the server name. So we are here on the same machine, that is the server 1, and here we will execute ssh-f-n, then -l, localhost 5555, and here we will mention the IP address of the web server, so that is the 192.168.1.126. It is the IP address, or you can mention the host name as well if DNS is configured there. And after that, we will mention here the username and the IP address of the machine that is connected in between them. So we are using server 2 here in between server 1 and server 3. And the IP address of this machine is 192.168.1.112. So we will mention this IP address here and we will press enter here. Now, here it is prompting us for the password, provide the same password, and here we go. We have successfully forwarded the port by using 3 servers here. Now, the tunnel is created and we can verify the same with the help of curl command. We will go on the first machine. We are already on this first server 1, and here we can execute the curl command to access the web page that is running on server 3. And here we go. We can easily see the web page details. And if we will execute the ps-ef command and we will grab SSH there again, we will be able to see that the port is forwarded there. And again, if we will go on this server number 3 where the web page is hosted and we execute the TCP dump command, there you can see the details of the packets. Again, how can we remove this port forwarding, or how can we close it? We will execute the kill command, kill-9, and we will mention the process ID, and we have successfully killed the process. Now there is no more port forwarding here. So in this way, we can use 3 servers for the local port forwarding. We can also use local port forwarding with gateway, but this time the difference is the communication between server 1 and server 3 is secured with the help of SSH tunnel, and we are trying to access it from server 2. So how can we do that? To do this, we will use this command. We will go on server number 1, that is the FTP server, and there we will execute SSH-G. -G is for the gateway. And if we are not using -G there, then we will open the ssh-config file in VI editor, and there we will enable the gateway, or we can directly use -G here. And after that, we will mention the semicolon and the port number, and then we will mention the IP address or the host name of the web server and the port number after that. So let me mention the IP address here, that is 192.168.1.126, and the port number. And after that, we will mention the same IP address after the username and at the rate, that is 192.168.1.126. And here it is asking for the password again, provide the password, and the tunnel is created, and you can verify the details with the help of ps-ef command. Here we go. Tunnel is created successfully, and we can easily see the web page from server 2, because this time we are using the server 1 as gateway. So in this case, we will be able to access the web page from server 2. Here we will execute the curl command, curl, and we will mention the IP address of our server 1, that is the FTP server. So let me check the IP address here, 192.168.1.119. We will mention this IP address here on server number 2 and press enter. And here we go. We are able to see the web page that is hosted on server 3. This is the same page, same web page that is hosted here on this machine. That means we are able to access this web page from server 2 by using this server 1 as gateway. And we can easily close this port forwarding by simply executing the kill-9 command as we did in the previous cases. So these were the types of local port forwarding which we have studied so far. Now the next type of port forwarding is the remote port forwarding, which is the exact opposite of local port forwarding. In this port forwarding, we forward the port on the remote computer or the remote machine. A remotely forwarded port is just like a local one, but the directions are reserved. This time, the TCP client is remote, its server is local, and a forwarded connection is initiated from the remote machine. And this is the syntax of this remote port forwarding. Here we use SSH-R, and then we mention the bind address, then semicolon remote port, then semicolon forwarded to the host, semicolon, and then we mention the port, and we mention connect to host, means the machine name or the machine IP address. And here you can see the details in the picture of this type of port forwarding. Here, this time we are using our web server as the local host, and we forward the port on this FTP server. So for this type of port forwarding, we use the SSH-R command. This is the command which we execute. So this time we will go on the web server, not on the FTP server. So we will log in here in the server 3. And here we will execute SSH-F-N-R for remote port forwarding, localhost. And here we mention the port number. And here we mention the IP address of our web server, that is 192.168.1.126, and the port number. And after that we mention the username and the machine host name or the IP address of the remote machine, that is 192.168.1.119, and press enter. Then it will prompt us for the password. Provide the password. Red Hat is the password in my case, and we have successfully created the tunnel. Now how can we verify it? So again, we can execute the ps-ef command on this web server, ps-ef, and we can grab SSH there, and here it will display the details of the port forwarding. Now we can verify the SSH tunnel. So this time we will go on the remote machine, that is the FTP server or the server 1, and here we execute the curl command, curl localhost, and mention the port number that we have mentioned in the previous command, that is 5555, and here it will display the web page. So this type of port forwarding is called as the remote port forwarding, because we have forwarded the port from the remote machine. And in order to remove it, we can again execute the kill command. So here we will go on the machine where we created this tunnel, and here we can check the process ID by ps-ef command, and this is the process ID. And after that we can kill it by using the kill command, kill-9 and the process ID. So we have successfully closed the tunnel as well. If you want to see the details of the packets, you can use the tcp dump command for that. Now the next type of port forwarding is called as the dynamic port forwarding. And dynamic port forwarding, actually it allows us to use the different port to access the service. Let us say if we need a quick way to exit our network by bypassing the firewall settings. Let me show you with an example. Let us suppose if I want to use, or if I want to access this web page that is hosted on web server, that is the server 3, but the firewall is not allowing me to access this port. That means the firewall has blocked the port number 80. So I won't be able to access this web page from server 1 because of the firewall. But by using the proxy port, I can connect to the web page from my server 1. So how can we achieve that? Let me show you. We can easily do that by the dynamic port forwarding here. let me first show you. Let me go on the server 1. And here we will try to access this web page by using the curl command just to check if the port number 80 is allowed through firewall or not. So here I will mention curl http colon double slash and the IP address of the web server and the port number, that is 80, and here we can access the web page and we can verify the details also from server 3. Here we can execute the firewall hyphen cmd command and here we can mention hyphen hyphen list all. So it will display all the ports and the services that are there added in the firewall. And here you can see that HTTP service is there with which we can easily connect from the port number 80 from the remote machine. Now in the next step, what I will do, I will remove this service or I will disallow this port in the firewall so that it will block the port number 80. So how can I do that? So on this web server I will execute firewall hyphen cmd command and here I will mention hyphen hyphen permanent hyphen hyphen remove hyphen service is equal to http. Now I can reload the firewall to make these changes. Firewall hyphen cmd hyphen hyphen reload. Now we will again go back to server 1 and we will again try to access this web page that is hosted on server 3. This time it will not let us allow to access the web page because the firewall has blocked the port number 80. We are not able to connect to this web page by using port number 80 here. So in this case we will use the dynamic port forwarding. Let me show you how can we do that. Here we will mention ssh-f hyphen capital N and hyphen D for dynamic port forwarding, and after that we can define the port and after that we can mention the username and the machine host name. The machine host name, or we can mention the IP address if the DNS is not configured in your local area network, and press enter. It will prompt you for the password, provide the same password, and the port forwarding has been enabled and we can verify the details by ps-ef command. Here we can grab the SSH. Here it is showing us the dynamic port forwarding. Now how can we access this web page since we have already configured the dynamic port forwarding there? So we can easily do that. We can use the curl command, but there we will mention the proxy. So let me mention curl hyphen hyphen proxy sox5h and then we can mention localhost and the port number and then again the web server address, that is http colon forward slash, and here I can mention the IP address, that is 192.168.1.126, and the port number. And this time we are able to access this web page through dynamic proxy, through the proxy or the dynamic port forwarding. So these were the types of different type of port forwardings that we use in Linux. So guys, I have shown you all the types of port forwarding that we can use to access the web pages or the services or the different ports in a secured way. So that's it for today's session. Thank you so much for your time. If you like this video, then do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, then please subscribe us and turn on the bell notification for such more videos. I'll see you in the next session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram, take care.